I've been using the CapCut video editing app and it's helped me grow my account on TikTok. In this video, I'm gonna share with you a CapCut video editing tutorial so that you can create videos like these. These are really powerful videos that you might have seen on social media. You're going to learn how to add really cool text to your videos using CapCut and also create videos that really stand out so that you can grow your account. Now, all you need to do for this CapCut video editing tutorial is download CapCut onto your phone. It's a free app that you can download. Of course, there's a pro version that you can pay for. I only use the free version, so I'm going to be sharing everything free that you can do on CapCut to create amazing videos. The main reason, well, one of the main reasons you want to use CapCut is because you want to create your own video library of original videos. Think of this like your mini Netflix of your own video content. Now, just think about it. If you post a video that you've edited in YouTube, Instagram, TikTok, you can't edit it or make any changes after you've posted it. But if you edit it in CapCut, it means that you can go back and make changes again and repost that video. Let's say that you want to create a video like this using the CapCut video editor. What you need to do is upload a bunch of clips. So I'm just going to show you exactly what you need to do. So open up the CapCut app and then see where new project is. Click that. And then you can select from all your video files. So this would be a really good video to do if you want to do like a day in the life, or maybe you want to do lots of quick snippets like that video I just showed you. So let's just add a bunch of different videos here. So you select the videos and then select add. And this is where the magic happens. So all those videos are going to get added to CapCut, as you can see there. Now, this is really important. You need to change the duration of each video. So I recommend that the clip length should be between 0.4 and 0.7 seconds long. This is a really effective strategy with getting people to watch your video right until the end, because if you've got a lot of these quick clips, it holds the viewer's attention. And that's what you want, right? You want to make sure that people are watching your video right until the end. So what you need to do is select the clip, and then you can select speed, which is down at the bottom there, and then select normal. And then what you want to do is move that circle. So as I mentioned, let's take it up to, we'll do 0.6. So we'll do 0.6 seconds. So what you need to do is select the plus sign and that will save that. And then you need to repeat that process for the next clip. So if you've got 9 clips there, like I do, for example, I would select each clip and then adjust the speed accordingly so that they're all 0.6 seconds long. What happens if you added a video clip but you just want to delete it in CapCut? So what you need to do is select that clip and then you can select delete right at the bottom there. So we can delete that. You can also trim the clip as well. So select the clip. Maybe you want to get rid of the start because you can see yourself turning on the camera or something. So what you can do is scroll across a little bit. See that white line there? That's where the cut will take place. So select split at the bottom, then select that smaller clip that you want to get rid of. So what you need to do is select edit and then delete. Another really helpful tip that you will find really valuable is that if you want to change the order of the clip, so let's say that you want to have a human appear at the start of the clip, because usually when people see other people, it's a little bit more engaging in the video. So you can actually hold the clip and then push it across so it appears at the start of the video. And that's a way that you can start to move around the different clips so that you can get a really good story to your video. If you make a mistake, don't worry. You can always click back that arrow up the top there and then your change will be undone. So now that all those changes are made, the next thing you might want to look at doing is actually reducing the volume in those video clips. The reason for this is that when you're filming a lot of different video, you might have different background noise. So one thing that you can do is just quickly select the different clips and then select volume. And then you can just turn the volume down. It's as easy as that. The reason why you want to reduce the sound in your video is because you don't want any background noise, especially if you are going to be adding a voiceover, and we'll be chatting about voiceovers later. It's really important, and I use CapCut all the time to add my voiceovers. Or if you add music, you don't really want background noise to be appearing. So just select all the clips and you can reduce the volume of those clips. Now, the next thing that you can do is also add music in the CapCut app. You might decide that you want to just edit your video and then choose music in Instagram when you upload the video, or maybe in TikTok. But there is also the option to add music. So I think it's really worth you knowing that as well. So if we go back to the bottom here, we can select on audio, and then you can select on sounds, and there you'll see lots of different sounds. So let's choose a sound. So this video is showing a yoga retreat that I recently went on. And so what I might like to do is also add a voiceover so that I can talk through the video and explain what's happening. So what you can do if you want to do that is you click on audio, and there at the bottom is voiceover. Do you see that there? So you select voiceover, and there's that turquoise button. So when you hold that and you can talk into CapCut, you can actually start to record your voiceover. So I'll record my voiceover, click the plus sign. So what you can see is the voiceover is added to your clip. And I love this feature so much because it's a really powerful way for you to stitch together clips like I've done, and then also overlay a story so you can share your experience or what's happening. And it's a really engaging way to create videos that are going to go viral. So if you want to see what the end result looks like, check out the link below. I posted it on my TikTok profile so you can see how this video all came together by using the CapCut features. I'm just going to interrupt my own video. I'm always asked, how can I make my videos go viral? How can I make my videos more engaging? So I've actually created a free guide. It's absolutely free. If you are interested in getting more views on your videos, then you might want to check out this guide. I'll leave a link down below so you can grab it and use it yourself. Now let's get back to it. So the next big thing is, how do you use CapCut video editing to create videos like this, which have really cool text on screen? And the reason why you want this type of text on screen is that it's really engaging, it allows you to connect with your viewer, and it's going to help you get more video views on your videos. So let me just show you how you can do that in CapCut. So let's pull up the app again. Let's select on new project. And here you want to select a video that you've already filmed. So I'm going to select this one here and then add. So now it's been added to the video editing app. Next, you want to select text, which is at the bottom there. So select that. And then you want to select auto captions. So select that. And then you will see that from video has already been selected. If it hasn't, then select that, because we want to transcribe the audio from your video. So then select start. And this is where the magic happens. So we can see that the text has been added to this video. Now I want to give you a bonus tip. Select the text, so select it, press on it, and at the bottom, can you see batch edit? Select that, and then this is where you can actually read over your text captions. I suggest that you do this because there might be a spelling mistake or something has been transcribed incorrectly. So quickly read over and make any changes. This is really important to do before we get to the fun stuff of making it look really bright and colorful. So now that you've checked all your text captions in CapCut, what you want to select is style, and then see font to the left, select that. And this is where you can choose the font that you want to use for your text captions in CapCut. So I'm going to scroll down here. Look how many there are to choose from. So I'm going to go with this one here, and I'm going to press the plus sign, which updates all of it. And then next you can go back into style, and then you can select the different style that you want for your text. So see how there's all those different colors there. I should also mention, this is another big bonus tip, make sure that apply to auto captions is ticked, because you just want to make sure that it's applied to all the auto captions that you have in your video. So next, I'm going to select this color here. Ooh, I like that. Looks good, right? Now you can also scroll across and have a look at effects. So maybe you want to apply some effects. So if we did, that's what it would look like there. Or if we want to have animation, I don't really recommend having too much animation in your text. because you want to make it really easy for the viewer just to read your text. So by having too much animation, it might make it quite hard to follow. So I'll leave that up to you. So test it out and see if you want to use animation, but I don't usually use it. So once you are happy with your style, I'm pretty happy with that, you can select the plus sign. Now, this is a really big tip. What I see a lot of people do on TikTok or YouTube or Instagram is that they position the text way too low. And that means that your text will be cut off by the social media caption, which we don't want, right? We want to make it really easy for someone to be able to read what is in your video. So you can select the text and just push it up here. And also another thing that you can do as well is that if you select that pencil sign, I think it's a pencil, it could be a pen, scroll down and you can see size there. We can actually make the text a lot bigger as well. So once you do that, you can position your text. It's looking pretty good, right? I like it. Looks really good. And once you're happy, select the plus sign again. Just do some more positioning. And that's how you add really cool text to your video using CapCut. I think it's game changing. It's going to make your videos stand out on whatever social media platform you're on, if it's YouTube, TikTok, Instagram, doesn't matter. I think it looks pretty amazing. If you have any questions about CapCut, let me know in the comments below. Thanks for sticking with me until the end. I'll see you next time, and until then, take care of yourself.